that I have. I like this square cutter best. But that's not what this is all about. What I want to talk to you today about is coloring the inside of pen blanks. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever made a pen and you get done, you think it's beautiful when you look at it, and lo and behold, there's the old brass tube showing through? Well, I have more than once. And the other thing, you know, sometimes I've made a couple where I went ahead and colored the brass tube, whether it be with paint or whatever, and I look at it and you can actually see the epoxy or the CA glue showing. Well, that got me thinking. I saw several videos on how guys fix this, but none of them seemed to do what I wanted to do. I tried a couple of them. I tried to paint. I actually painted the inside of the tube. I cleaned it good, and then I used a Bulldog primer, which is the same kind of primer you use for painting, like plastic bumpers on cars. It's supposed to make anything stick to anything. And then I used a black aluminum wheel paint, which I had painted my grandson's wheels about a year ago on his Mustang. And I mean, they don't have a chip on them today, so I said, well, that's some fine paint. So that's what I used. So I did all that, and I let it dry a sufficient time, started turning it, and within just a little while, it spun out. So I looked at it, and I pulled out a black tube. So the paint had given up against the blank itself. It had stuck fine to the tube. So you know, obviously that wasn't going to work for him. So anyway, I believe I've got the solution to it. I just got done making this pen. I'm going to show you some still pictures here in a minute. I just got done making this one, and that's what this video is going to be about, how to make this one. And here's one I made a few days ago. And it has no painting inside of any kind. And you can see the brass tube, and you can see where the CA glue did or did not adhere. So I'm going to put a couple still pictures on here so maybe you can see better details. I believe I have a solution. And my solution is by using ink. I found these on Amazon. Get them up here where you can see them. And it's an array of different colors of indelible ink. And in here you have, you know, here's some nice sort of a greenish colored. Here's a blue. Come on around here. Here's a nice gold. There's a beautiful purple. And there's a white. There's another, a real pretty green. And here's the red. That's what I'm going to be using today. Let's see what we got here. There's a black. And there's a sort of a brownish gold color. The names are on them. I don't know what they are. There's a silver. See, we're back. I think we're back around to the green. There's 10 of them here. And they were $18.80 on Amazon. And it's not very much in there, but I'd probably do, I don't know, maybe 50, 60 pens on one of them. So anyway, I'm going to get on with the video and show you how I did this. I think it turned out quite successful. So let's just proceed and see how we
use a brush. But,
and I always pour me up just a little bit of acetone. And I clean out the inside just a little bit like that. So you can see what I'm doing. And I do them both like that. It evaporates and dries very quickly. So, you know, just to get any residue and make it a little sticky. Get those dry. Now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use the red. Probably get it all over me and be really sorry, but won't be the first time. I've already got it on me. And here, I'm going to come from this end to try to keep it. See if I can get it where you can see. I'm going to come inside. And you can see it's painting up real pretty. Try not to get it on the ends. You see what I'm doing? So, get it really colored up best I can. I'm going to do both of them like that. And in addition to that, I'm going to put some coloring on the tubes themselves. Okay. I believe that's going to end up being halfway pretty. So there's one over. And this is going to work. I don't have any reason why it won't. So okay, that's that. And it looked like I got them pretty covered in there. And it dries fairly quick. All right, so much for that. Done it real good. Make a mess. Okay, then I'm going to take a red marker here. I don't know if this is necessary or not, but I'm going to go ahead. So we're going to do that, and I'm going to let this sit probably 15, 20 minutes before I epoxy them up. So I'll get back with you when I do that, and then we'll see what we've got. So I'll talk to you a little bit later. All right, well, I'm back. I think I've had plenty of time. I checked a little bit of ink on the sides here, and you can't get it off, so I think it's going to stick. I'm going to use a cheap old Harbor Freight epoxy. Sometimes they run this stuff on sale for 99 cents, so I usually buy a bunch of it, and it's fine for putting the pin tubes. And here's a little trick I've used for quite a few years. Use the bottom of a Coke can to mix my epoxy in. Nice dished out little area. Zero problem, no mess. When you're done, it's pretty close to 50-50. When you're done, throw it in the trash. Now mix this up until it gets nice and milky looking. Looking good. It doesn't take a whole lot because actually the epoxy on the tubes is really more for keeping them spinning out when you're turning than they are for anything else anyway. So I'm not going to put a whole lot. I'm using the wrong one. Sorry about that. I'm going to put a whole lot on. I don't think they're not going to go anywhere. I'm going to put a little bit of this one into here. Twist it as you go until you hit the tape. And make sure it's buddied right there. There we go. 5 minutes or so, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whatever. Come back and we'll move into the other room where the lathe is. That's where I'm going to press them up. Then we'll see what we've got. Well, I almost screwed up on this second one. You see this little red ring right here? That replaces the band that normally goes in there. So my tube needed to slide past there because the mechanism goes there and it slides in to make sure your pin tip comes out right. So that's what that little red ring is whenever I C8 them together. So the tube is actually inside there a quarter inch. So I'll be able to take care of that. Put them down, let them sit up, and we'll see you in the lathe room. Bye. Okay, let's put this thing together. I am extremely pleased with how this looks. I'm going to try to get a picture right here. You don't see any brass in there. In fact, the red makes the blue show up quite well. Here's the other piece. Looks very good. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do a little backwards here. I'm going to put the cap on first on the end. And I've got this in here because the tube doesn't run all the way, so I didn't want to take a chance on pushing it out. So I'm going to put the cap and the clip on. Sometimes I don't use a clip, and sometimes I do. Always keep everything in a plastic bag, a plastic container, in other words. Some days I can't talk either. And we'll put this on here, like so. Here, like so, and we'll begin the pressing procedure. Keep it straight and push. And we're done. That's that. That looks real good. I think everything's backwards. All right, so that's done. Now I'm going to take the other part and I'm going to press the tip in right here. And I'm going to bring this up a little closer to there. Set it up. And pressing we will go. Here we go. That's that. Okay. And I'm gonna press this in up to the little mark. Start right there. Oop, maybe, maybe not. Here we go. Back it off again. Make sure I got it straight. Tighten it up. Not looking good. Right to the mark. All right. And take this. I get everything backwards. Take this and put it in. Make sure it comes through right. Well, it looks like I've got to do a little bit more. A little bit more pressing here. I can do that. Here we go. Yeah, just about perfect. Maybe a little long. Anyway, that's that. All right. This part on. And we have it, ladies and gentlemen. That's all it is to it. Nothing to it. Very different, I would say. Thank you very much for your time. Coloring the inside with ink, I say, is a rousing success. Well, I made this pen a little bit backwards today, but I was trying to prove a point. I turned the outside before I put the brass tubes in, but I wanted to demonstrate how the ink did the job, and it appears like it works quite well. If I do another one, I believe when I put the tubes in, well, I will put them in first, but I'll give it a little bit more time because I do spy just a hair of brass color right there, and that may come from sliding the tube in and giving it a little twist. So next time I will either use CA glue or I will just slide it in and not twist it, because it may have a tendency to dissolve the ink. But overall, I'm very pleased, and I think this is the way I'm going to do them henceforth. So I want to thank you for your time, and I'll be making some more as time goes by. So take care, and I'll see you later.